so much for me here. So much beauty.
Oh, beauty? That's never been a problem for me. Faces of old people, young girls, tastefully arranged cripples. Beautiful. But it won't do, you see. The world is not beautiful. At last, I've discovered that. And I'm an old fool who's not been telling the truth.
That painting of Liz on the sofa? That was the truth, surely. What is the truth, then?
That the world is ugly, cruel. It is darkness, and the terrible things we do to one another. The sooner we're out of it, the better.
Is that all you see now?
You must wonder what strange corner of the world you've wandered into.
I seem to find three unhappy women under one roof.
Unhappy?
Liz about her baby, Camilla, I don't know, about her life, I think, and you about the whole world.
You have quickly summed us up. The baby's teething. Liz will soon stop fussing. She's never miserable for long. Camilla. Mm-hmm. She's at a forked road. Believes that what she doesn't take now, she will never have and dwindle into an old maid. I am a terrible example to her. Her job shows her others. And I am indeed unhappy about the world.
Perhaps you'll find your way through.
No time. I'm an old woman. But I have been thinking there might be one more painting in me. Just one.
Will it be beautiful?
I think you may be the devil come to tempt me.
I am your friend and follower, wherever you may go. To you.
Thanks, old man. Isn't it?
And yet I'm not quite sure you enjoy mixing with the common herd.
Thank
Mr. Beddoes is such a nice man, don't you think?
Yes, indeed. A good fellow. I wish he hadn't given her that toffee afterward. I'm afraid it'll make her ill.
Are you really worried about that? Or how it looks for the vicar's wife to be eating such a thing?
You detest me and suspect the worst of me. You put words into my mouth I've never said, and thoughts into my mind I never could think.
Why sound so surprised? Never hidden the fact that I detest you.
But why? Why single me out?
Because you singled out Liz. Otherwise, I would ignore you. She is dearer to me than anyone in the world. So how could I ignore her husband?
I feel I've known you for many years. I've looked at you so much, hanging above my fireplace.
Oh, that. I don't think it looks much like me, actually.
What were you thinking about when it was being painted? You know, I've often wondered.
About nothing, I should think. I often go for long stretches thinking about nothing. Mooning Arthur Balsam.
Bumper cars.
Oh, I can't.
Don't you want to go on the bumper car?
I must go. I've got an appointment.
Sorry. I got held up. I was working on the book, you see, and...
You weren't in your room. I asked at the desk.
I was walking around with it, you know. Worrying over it.
Doesn't matter.
You sure?
I saw a good one here the other day. Here. My dear husband, Alfred. Life is never what it seems. He is not gone. He only dreams. Like hell he does.
You shouldn't always be on your dignity, you know. How can you have any fun if you can't forget yourself?
Why do you say that? Because I don't laugh at your jokes? Right. I am unbending.
You're okay. Just a bit serious. Flight Sergeant Michael Appleby. 11th of October, 1943. Good luck, chum.
I saw you the other day. You were with a girl.
Where?
Outside the Griffin.
Oh, her. That was nothing. I was waiting for you, and you never showed up.
You should have saved me from that girl.
Not fair to leave a man at a loose end.
I know nothing about men.
Weren't you ever in love?
There was somebody. I was 18. Well, he got bored. It was very ordinary. I should have got over it, given myself a second chance. Liz would have given herself a second chance. But I,
Maybe you haven't missed much. Love? It's all a bloody game. First few days, great. Then you know everything you're supposed to do, everything you're supposed to say. You're stuck with this woman you have to talk to and kiss and all the rest of it.
So bloody boring!
But you don't want all that, do you? You don't expect anything?
What trouble are you in? You told me you were in trouble.
Well, it's money.
Are you in debt? What are you going to do?
Guess I'll have to make a move soon. Moonlight flit. Don't worry. It's all a game to me. It gives me something to do.
A job would give you that. Couldn't you borrow the money to tide you over?
Who'd lend it to me?
I would.
I don't borrow money from women.
It would be better than prison, wouldn't it?
You wouldn't like to see me in a cell?
You deserve better. You're still suffering from the war. You need to recover. You wouldn't do anything really bad.
I said, would you marry me?
Frances has shooed me away till supper. She's stretching a canvas. I think she's going to make a new painting.
What's that?
Script. A film they want me to do.
Don't appear to be enjoying it.
No. It's not good. It needs work.
Is that important? How do you get such work? I mean, do you go to the labor exchange or do they advertise in the papers?
Do you want to become a scriptwriter?
No. No, I was thinking for a friend. He's a writer. He's writing a book. At least he's thinking of writing a book. No, it's absurd.
Do you want me to talk to him?
No. Really, it's absurd.
Camilla, I was wondering, when you go back to town, perhaps we could have lunch. Or go to the belly, or, I don't know, something else, if you prefer.
Oh, yes. Thank you. Yes?
Afternoon. I hope you don't mind. I used to live in this house when I was a boy, and, well, I was just passing with my fiancée, and, well, I had an urge to show it to her. If you wouldn't mind.
Do you find there's a bit of a nip in the air, dear? Sometimes she leaves it a bit too late. You understand? You should have seen her before the war. Oh, she was ever so lively. You couldn't hold her down.
My mother used to sit just where you are.
Going out, Margie?
Yeah. My daughter.
So long, Mum.
So long. Where do they get these expressions?
Don't tell me. This is the little bedroom.
Where I slept.
That is the lavvy, dear. You must be thinking of the room just above. Margie's room. That naughty girl.
Is this it?
Yeah. I used to reach out and tear this off. My mother would say, my mother.
Why did you say I was your fiancé?
Bit of a joke. I like pretending things.
They are lies.
Yes, miss.
In the end, you won't know what's real.
That's true.
Why are you so frightened?
I've got to see you tomorrow.
Why?
I want to tell you something. I was going to tell you yesterday, but then we went to that house instead. Why did we go to that house?
It was the house you grew up in. You wanted to show it to me.
Oh, yeah, right.
What is really wrong with you?
I've never known. I think I'm being watched. There's this fella. He's always there. In the street, I look up. He's watching me. And the griffin, he's there too.
Why should anybody be watching you?
See me tomorrow.
I can't. We go on a picnic tomorrow.
I like picnics.
Oh, I don't think...
Oh, sure. Right. I wouldn't fit in, would I? Forget it.
I could come down afterwards. In the evening.
Last night... I thought God had sent you to me. To help me
To do what?
What a mess that house was, and that hack and that little tart. If my mother could have seen all that.
She didn't see it. Not here. It doesn't touch her. I am here. I am real.
Beautiful morning.
Arthur says it's going to rain.
For sure.
But Arthur has privileged information, you know.
Thank you. Right. You ready?
No war!
I beg your pardon?
You came too far.
Sorry.
Try again.
This time.
I think that's a four.
Poor man.
Come on, fellows.
Darling, let's have a drink. Then you can bowl to me.
I can't think why anybody said it would rain today.
What a perfect day.
It's the sort of day old people remember as the end of something. The last day before the Great War. The day the old Queen died, the end of an era. There never was such weather again, they say.
My mother used to talk like that.
That's how it was.
I was a little boy when the Great War started. They hurried us away from the coast in case the Germans landed.
You're all frightening me. It's as if something terrible would happen.
Oh, this time it'll be the other way around. This time we shall look back and say it was the end of all our troubles that day. The last day of sadness.
People never do say that.
They're right not to. Things keep getting worse.
Only if you take the short view, surely.
I take the view of 80 years. Which is as much as I can manage or be interested in.
But you care about the future of mankind?
Not in the least.
You care about Liz, for instance?
Elizabeth is not a child anymore. She must take care of herself. In fact, all of us should take care of ourselves. It seems to me of the highest importance.
I shall start to howl in a minute. Come on. Bowl the ball to me.
But you always miss.
Oh, can't you just bowl the bloody ball to me?
Such a day.
Cigarette?
Darling, are you all right?
Yes.
Darling, I'm sorry.
It's all right, Arthur.
I've been meaning to say... Well, I know that sometimes it is difficult for you. I know that sometimes I can be...
unbearable?
Yes. I just wanted to thank you for putting up with me.
Why did you marry me, Arthur?
Because I loved you. We'll always love you.
Yes.
I was right. Raining.
I was right. It's raining. It's raining. you want it cheap or do you want it good? Right, well, that's what I want, and I would strongly suggest it. Look, I'll get back to you. What do you want?
I came to ask you that. What the devil is it?
I don't know what you mean.
Like hell. You've been spying on me since you came here. Wherever I go, watching me. What do you want?
Nothing.
Lie to me. What is it?
I wanted...
Yes?
To talk to you. About script writing.
Do you think I'm crazy?
No, No. Look, I don't want anything from you. I want nothing to do with you unless... Unless you hurt anyone I care for.
Going out? Yes. Morland's coming up later.
Then I shall miss him. I have to see Richard. He's going away tomorrow. The day after. Perhaps he'll write to me. It helps me to face next term to believe that he will.
Are you so lonely? Cam?
Yes. I am so lonely. You couldn't imagine how much. You have Harry. And you have Arthur.
Cam.
Doesn't borrow money from women, but perhaps he will accept a gift.
You looked so serious. I was frightened to disturb you.
I was dreaming I was a concert pianist, the audience hanging on my every note.
I've had dreams like that. During the war, I charged a German machine gun nurse single-handed.
And the truth?
I was in an army film unit at Wembley. Francis is working. And Camilla?
Gone out. Audience hushed, the orchestra fading out, and me alone, my white hands going up and down the keys.
Thank you.
finished working?
Yes. I've finished working. It was quite a beautiful painting. Very pretty. I couldn't do it. I can't pretend. Not even for you. No. You must let me be finished. You know, I can never let you make a film about me. You must wait till I'm dead. I picked these yesterday. See? They're already faded. All I can give you.
It's only thunder.
Come on.
Let's go upstairs.
Go any further.
Don't be silly.
I don't want to stay here. I can't bear it.
But I want you to stay. I've got something to tell you.
You're hurting me.
Why didn't you say so? You see, I killed a girl. That's what I wanted to tell you.
Yes.
You've no need to worry. Never hurt you. I told you that once, didn't I? I meant it.
I haven't finished telling you!
I can't explain it exactly. I think it's boredom, mostly. I reckon I've been bored all my life. I remember when I was a kid, sitting on my bed, hours and hours, wondering what to do, sitting around the house. Not that house we went to. Nothing so grand. I was never in that house before in my life. I was never in this town either. Bit of a joke. That's a way to fight boredom. Have a joke. Have a laugh. also frightening people. That's another way that excited me always. I felt good. Powerful. Then it'd go away again. I'd be back to where I was. Bored. Bored. Eternity. Till the next time. I saw someone looking at me. And there was this girl. She was a nervous little thing. And I scared her to death. Oh, true. No. I strangled her.
Was it she done to you?
Done to me? I was wondering if maybe death was more interesting than love. And... well, there she was.
Are you sorry now?
I didn't even remember her name till I saw it in the papers.
What are you going to do?
Oh, I'll move on. Another town. Get stuck into my book. I haven't managed to do much here.
They'll catch you in the end.
Yes, I figure they will.
I've listened to you. Now, can we go?
No, it's still raining. Maybe we could stay here for a while. Get some wood. Have a fire.
Some people see the smoke.
There's no one to see. I want you to help me through this. But God wants it.
But I must be getting back. They'll be wondering. They'll be looking for me.
You're trying to trick me. Do you think I'm going to strangle you? How could I do that? I told you I'd never hurt you. Didn't I?
Over and over again.
Why don't you go? I thought you'd stand by me. More for me. I always lose people when I tell them the truth about me. All my life. I thought you'd be different.
I don't know how to.
Scarborough. I'm going to Scarborough.